Hello, good morning everyone. Today I am teaching to you class 8 science subject, chapter 2, topic is harmful microorganisms. Chapter 2. This chapter about microorganisms. Some microorganisms, they behave like friend for us, and some are behave for foe for us, means enemy for us. Means foe means they are, some of the microorganisms are harmful for us. Today I am teaching you about the how some microorganisms are harmful for us and how their effects are shown on our body. In the continuation of this chapter, our topic is harmful microorganisms. The harmful microorganisms. Some of the microorganisms are harmful for the human beings because they causes some diseases in our body, and some are also harmful for the animals and the plants. So those organisms which are harmful for us means they causes diseases are called pathogens. Pathogens are the microorganism. These are the microorganism which causes some diseases. The microorganism which causes some diseases are called pathogens. Like AIDS virus, it causes a disease. HIV virus causes a disease that is called AIDS virus. AIDS full form is acquired immuno deficiency syndrome. A disease which affect our immunity system. It is caused by a virus, and the name of the disease is AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Some of disease like chickenpox, tuberculosis, in short form it is called TB. Tuberculosis, a disease which is caused by a bacteria, tubular bacillus bacteria. Chickenpox caused by a virus. So some are the bacteria viruses and also fungi. These are the microorganisms Not all, but some bacteria, viruses, fungi, and other microorganisms causes diseases into the human being, and it also causes some diseases in plants and animals. So these harmful, what are these? This is harmful bacteria, viruses and fungi are called pathogens. These are called pathogens. So we can say that pathogens are those microorganisms, which cause diseases are called pathogens. Means we can say that those microorganisms which cause diseases are called pathogens, like bacteria, virus, fungi, AIDS virus, and also malaria and dengue caused by some viruses and protozoa. These are called pathogens. How they enter in our body? The harmful microorganisms enter our body through air, water, or the contaminated food, by eating the contaminated food. Means the air which we breathe, the harmful microorganisms comes into the air, and when we breathe it enters in our body and affect our health. Water we drink, some of the microorganisms falls into water, and when we drink it affect our body easily while entering in our body. And if we eat contaminated food, it will also affect our health. So we can say that these harmful microorganisms enters in our body mainly by three ways: through air, through water, and through taking the contaminated food. So be secure when we eat a food, it is not contaminated. It should not be contaminated food. And another factor is if an infected person is come closer to us, a healthy person, the infected person also affect the healthy person. So more clearly we can say that the diseases spread by also with the infected person when it come closer to a healthy person, the healthy person also is affected by the disease. And if a healthy person is affected by the infected person, this way of causing or spraying a disease is called communicable disease. Means if an infected person affects a healthy person through air, water, food or physical contact and it causes some diseases into the healthy person, into the body of a healthy person, this type of diseases are called communicable diseases. Some of the communicable diseases are like common cold, cholera, chickenpox, malaria, AIDS, etc. AIDS is also a communicable disease. So, what are communicable diseases? Those microbial diseases which can spread from an infected person to a healthy person by which way? Through air, water, food or physical contact, etc., are called communicable diseases. For example, like cholera, tuberculosis, that is called TB, malaria, etc., AIDS also comes into the communicable diseases. So, our next heading is, what are the ways these communicable diseases can spread? So, the communicable diseases can occur and spread in the following ways. What are the ways through which these communicable diseases can be spread? Already I said these diseases can be spread through air, food, water, but some are also other factors which are responsible for the spreading the disease. Let us know about it. The communicable disease is spread by breathing of air if the air containing microorganisms means harmful microorganism, more precisely we can say that harmful microorganisms. If we breathe the air and the air contains some harmful microorganisms, then we are affected by the communicable disease. The next way is if we take, means by taking infected or contaminated food or water. Some of the communicable diseases also is spread by mosquito bites, means it will also spread through some insect bites like malaria, a disease which is spread by the mosquito bites. Another factor is it may be spread by sharing infected injection needles. It will also spread by physical contact with an infected person. These are the ways a communicable disease can be spread: by breathing of air, if the air contains some harmful microorganism, they easily enter in our body and affect our health. By taking infected food and water, also it will spread by insect bites like mosquito bites. They cause malaria disease, and also dengue disease is caused by a virus. It will also spread by a mosquito bite. Also, by sharing the infected injection needles, it will cause a communicable disease like HIV. And also, if we in contact with the infected person, they may be spread the some communicable diseases like common cold, influenza. So these are the ways by which a communicable disease may be spread from one person to another person. So next topic is how can we prevent these communicable diseases? These are the cause by which a communicable disease is spread. And the next topic is by which way we can stop or prevent these communicable diseases. So next topic is prevention of communicable diseases. Prevention of communicable diseases. Some of the methods for preventing the occurrence and spreading of communicable diseases. Their prevention may be done in what way the disease is spread. For example, this disease is spread by breathing of air. So when we breathe or sneezing, always use handkerchief or cloth. By taking infected food, the disease is spread. So when if you prevent the disease, always take a fresh food and fresh water. Drink fresh water. The disease also is spread by an insect bite. So to prevent the disease, we should use or sleep in a net mesh or wire mesh over our beds. The next is the disease is also spread by sharing the injection needles. So, if we want to prevent the disease, always must be use a fresh needle. So, here, what I am trying to say? I am trying to say that what are the causes and what are the ways the disease is spread, it will also be prevented if we stop these spraying ways of the disease. If the disease is spread by the physical contact with an infected person, please be secure. Do not come closer to an infected person. Okay? And one also important way to prevent from these communicable diseases are should go for the vaccination at proper time. Now let write one by one ways. By doing so, we can prevent ourselves from the spreading of these communicable diseases. Always use a handkerchief while sneezing. The second way is always eat a fresh food. Always eat a fresh food and drink clean and safe water. If you go for the sleeping, use nets over your beds. We should protect ourselves from mosquito bite by using mosquito nets over our beds while sleeping. We should make sure always use a fresh syringe and needles. We should always use a fresh syringe and needles. Always avoid physical contact with an infected person. Always avoid physical contact with an infected person. And the last one is, we should take vaccination at proper time. We should take vaccination at proper time. By following these ways, we can prevent ourselves from these communicable diseases. Okay, thank you. Next topic I will discuss in my next class, and on the basis of this class I will give you some question for your homework, and I hope that all of you do this question.